now acknowledge our sins, and so prepare our sorrows to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Not crying out, not shouting, not making his voice heard in the street. A bruised reed he shall not break, and a smoldering wick he shall not quench, until he establishes justice on the earth. The coastlands will wait for his teaching. I, the Lord, have called you for the victory of justice. I have grasped you by the hand. I formed you and set you as a covenant of the people, a light for the nations, to open the eyes of the blind, to bring out prisoners from confinement, and from the dungeon those who live in darkness. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
filled with expectation, and all were asking in their hearts whether John might be the Christ. John answered them all, saying, I am baptizing you with water, but one mightier than I is coming. I am not worthy to loosen the thongs of his sandals. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. After all the people had been baptized, and Jesus also had been baptized and was praying, heaven was opened, and the Holy Spirit descended upon him in the bodily form like a dove. And a voice came from heaven, You are my beloved Son, with you I am well pleased. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Heaven was opened, and the Holy Spirit descended upon him in bodily form like a dove. And a voice came from heaven, You are my beloved Son. With you I am well pleased. Today we celebrate the baptism of the Lord as the ending of our Christmas season. In this great theophany, this great appearance of the Holy Trinity for all to see, our eyes are made new by the Spirit as we celebrate that God has completed revelation in His Son, Jesus Christ. That we, who have been baptized by water and Spirit, are heirs now to the heavenly kingdom and to the grandeur of God's very life. To understand how great an event this is, we must first understand Revelation. The Lord throughout the Old Testament attempted again and again to bring the Israelites close to His heart. He wanted to set aside a people so that the whole world might be open to His indwelling. And so He kept inviting them with covenant after covenant to come closer to Him. But the Israelites were all too human. They were like us all too much. And like the sinners that we all are, we often have hardened hearts. In that, the greatest time when God appeared to man before this, our coming of our Savior Jesus Christ, was on Sinai, when the Lord decided that Moses would see His back. So Moses had the people of Israel assemble and be ready for this. And they did so by hiding in their tents. And when the presence of God came, they shook with fear and trembled as the very earth seemed to move. Moses himself, when he was given the command, looked up and saw God's back, and himself had an air, a light that would come from his face from that moment forward, because he had seen God. Afterwards, the Israelites made it clear to Moses, Never shall that happen again. You and you alone have to converse with the Lord, for His presence is too much for us. We are too low, and He is too high. With Christ, God has done better than He had with Moses. He did not set aside a mere man, but became man, to dwell among us in all things. With His baptism, Christ took on our sins. He identified Himself with the iniquity of Israel, of the whole fallen human race. When He rose from the waters of the Jordan, though, He was able to be shown fully as man and fully as God. The Spirit descended upon Him, and the voice from heaven the Father proclaimed his love and satisfaction with the Son. And God revealed himself to be more than we could have ever imagined. A communion, a trinity of persons, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. The Greek word for this is theophany, the showing of God, the appearance of God. But Christ's baptism is even more than that. I am baptizing you with water, but one mightier than I is coming. I am not worthy to loosen the thongs of his sandals. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. My dear brothers and sisters, the Holy Spirit is the very bond of charity between Father and Son. By giving it to us, the Lord offers us his very life, the very crux of being divine, is offered to us in the sacraments. But like the Israelites, we also often find ourselves not ready for God's presence. We find our brokenness, our sorrows, our disappointments to weigh us down. We have been given the great season of Christmas to lift our hearts and to teach our minds to become fixed on our Lord, on the goodness of God, his plan for our salvation. This is Christian hope to have in our memory, to hold dear to us the saving works of God that he has accomplished, of the works we have seen him do in our own lives. On this solemnity of the baptism of our Lord, may we remember our own baptism, our own coming to divine life, and may we be inspired and encouraged to remove whatever keeps us, whatever blocks us from grace, that we might have the true indwelling of the Spirit, the true indwelling of God in us, that the whole world might see and marvel at what God does in our lives.
Truth and power, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
for those entrusted with the work of government, that they may serve the cause of right and strive to establish true justice on earth, we pray to the Lord. For those who have become lukewarm in their faith, that the Spirit given in their baptism will rekindle faith and love in their hearts, we pray to the Lord. And for ourselves and our community, that we may eagerly follow Christ's call at our baptism and establish true justice on earth, we pray to the Lord. For those who are sick, especially Father Donnelly, Rose Hutchinson, Leo Werfel, Chuck Dentz, Jake Hokish, and Tim Childress, we pray to the Lord. And especially for those who have died, including Robert Mullins and Ann Harmon, for whom this Mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord.
Heavenly Father, hear these our prayers. Answer them according to your holy will, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our hymn for the presentation of the gifts can be found in your Gather Book, number 321, on Jordan's Bank.
Of your faithful may be transformed by the sacrifice of him who will, in his compassion, to wash away the sins of the world, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. From the waters of the Jordan, we reveal the signs and wonders, a new baptism, that through the voice that came down from heaven, you might come to believe in your word dwelling among us, and by the Spirit descending in the likeness of a dove, you might know that Christ, your servant, has been anointed with the oil of gladness and sent to bring the good news to the poor. And so, the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty, without end, we are glad.
Mystery of faith.
forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrifice of victims, by whose death your will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us into an offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance of your land, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed Joseph the spouse, the blessed apostles, and the glorious fathers, and all the saints, and whose constant intercession in your presence we will offer for unfailing accounts. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your open church on earth with your servant, Francis, our Pope, and Richard, our Bishop, the order bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you've gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O Lord, O Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To honor our brothers and sisters, to all who are pleasing to you, at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom, that we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom we saw the world, all that is good.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Thank you.
him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those called the sons of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the words and the soul shall
be. This is he of whom John said, I have seen and have given witness that this is the Son of God.
Our communion song can be found in your data book, number 502, Come to the Water.
Thank you.
sent your only begotten Son, we may be your children in name and in truth, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We do have a couple of announcements. First, there will be a Calamity Special Collection next week. This collection will be for the humanitarian and church needs of the severe weather in the South and Midwest regions of our country. All checks should be made out to Immaculate Conception Church with the memo marked 2015-2016 Calamity Special Collection. Second, reverse raffle tickets are still available and being sold after the masses. If you haven't gotten one, this is your chance to get lucky. I know I am never lucky with such things. Now we buy at least one myself. So there's at least one loser here. So please, support the parish's fundraiser. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth and proclaim the gospel with your life.
Thanks be to God.
The closing song can be found in your gather book, number 507, I Want to Walk as a Child of the Light.